Hi, my name is Chris Henry, and I'm a senior scientist at Waters Corporation based in the UK. I'm part of the scientific operations group working on LCMS solutions for small mole pharmaceuticals with a focus on impurity workflows. And here I'd like to talk about the Waters ACQUITY RDa Detector for forced degradation studies. Forced degradation is the intentional breakdown of drug substance or drug product to an appropriate level to establish what degradation products are produced. For example, degradation by acidic, basic, oxidative, or UV exposure ensures pharmaceutical companies have the necessary analytical methodologies in place early in the development process to ensure potential impurities are identified early on. The information obtained from a forced degradation study can be utilized in several other areas of development, including analytical methods development, formulation development, and identification of possible genotoxic degradants, as well as many others. Characterization of any degradants detected is critical to assess potential toxicity or negative impact on drug efficacy. Drug characterization is often carried out using NMR or high-resolution mass spectrometry. These instruments can be expensive, require expertise and time-consuming data interpretation. With the ACQUITY RDa Detector, access to high-resolution mass spectral data is accessible to scientists with a wide range of analytical expertise. The Waters ACQUITY RDa Detector is a bench-top time-of-flight instrument introduced to facilitate the deployment of accurate mass measurement technology, incorporating routine workflows and removing the need for high-resolution mass spectrometry expertise. Similar to the ACQUITY QDa Detector, the RDA automatically sets up and calibrates with the push of a button. Health systems monitor for problems and provides guidance on resolving them. Full scan with fragmentation function allows for cone voltage ramping to simultaneously acquire both high and low energy mass spectra to aid in pathway profiling, providing insight into the nature and origin of any degradant observed. The system is controlled by the compliant ready Unify application as part of the Waters Connect software platform. Streamlined workflows within Unify allow for a stepwise investigation of the data, enabling quick appraisal of any degradants produced to detailed profiling of degradants over time. Within Unify, a typical targeted workflow would involve creating a library of known degradants using mole files, which are text files containing structural information for a single compound, and using that library to screen the data collected for any degradants that have been formed during the experiment. As an example, a targeted workflow has been set up to assess the degradation of the anti-diabetic drug glipizide under acidic, basic, and oxidative conditions. Here, using the processing method within Unify, we have imported mole files of the glipizide parent drug and 5 known impurities. Unify will use this information to interrogate the data generated and intelligently assign identified compounds and fragments. The binary compare workflow step can be used for an initial appraisal of the incubated compound. This involves selecting a reference sample, in this case the T equals 0 minutes degradation, and a degraded sample incubated for 60 minutes at 80 degrees centigrade are compared. We can clearly see a peak at 2.41 minutes present in the degraded sample only. The mass spectra is displayed and Unify has automatically identified the degradant as impurity 5 and visualized the structure. Now let's take a deeper dive into the data. We have selected the workflow step entitled impurity review. This time we have chosen the sample incubated under acidic conditions for 120 minutes at 80 degrees C. The component summary table is highlighted, which shows that Unify has identified glipizide parent compounds along with impurities 2 and 3, with the latter selected. On the right-hand side of the screen, we have the low-energy channel at the top showing the mass spectra and structure for impurity 3. On the bottom, we see the high-energy channel acquired simultaneously, showing the fragments generated from this degradant. Again, the structures are automatically visualized, with the charge-retaining portion highlighted. The trend plot workflow step was modified to show the spread of impurity generation over all the time points tested, giving an indication of glipizide's relative stability under all stress conditions used. As can clearly be seen from these graphs, impurity 2 and 3 are generated under predominantly acidic and oxidative conditions. Impurity 5 exclusively under basic conditions, and the unknown oxidation product, tentatively assigned by Unify as glipizide plus O2, generated under oxidative conditions only, which we will now investigate further in the non-targeted section. For an initial appraisal of the unknown peak, again the binary compare function was used. Here we have the T equals 0 minutes for oxidative degradation as a reference, and for the unknown, the T equals 180 minutes at 80 degrees centigrade oxidative degradation. The peak highlighted in the targeted phase of the work is present only at the degraded sample at retention time 3.14 minutes. It's important in pharmaceutical development when investigating an unknown peak to determine whether the detected component is derived from the parent drug. To establish a structural relationship between the suspected degradant and the API, we can import the fragment data from the API into the processing method as expected fragments. The top 10 intensity fragments have been selected along with any potential or expected transformations. The oxidatively stressed sample is then reprocessed with this additional information. We can see here that 6 fragment ions that have been automatically assigned by Unify from the structure of the API are also detected in the high energy data of the suspected degradant and visualized. The presence of 6 fragment ions common to both the API and the suspected degradant strongly indicates the peak is structurally related to glipizide. The ACQUITY RDa detector provides routine access to accurate mass measurements for targeted and non-targeted force degradation studies for a wide range of mass spectrometry expertise. Automatic identification and visualization of degradants and fragment ions is easily achievable without the need for manual interpretation. Visualization of potential structural fragment ion detection to aid in pathway profiling studies. Streamlined workflows within Unify allow for a stepwise investigation of the data, allowing quick appraisal of degradants produced to detailed profile on degradants over time. The Waters Connect platform allows for a fully 21 CFR Part 11 compliant end-to-end workflow creation for routine analysis of force degradation studies. With the ACQUITY RDa detector, high-resolution mass spectrometry becomes routine. And to make your sample preparation even more efficient, you can use the Andrew Alliance Plus. The ACQUITY RDa detector, the confidence of accurate mass measurements with the minimum of effort.